स्टैंडर्ड नहीं, एक्सरसाइज 6.3, थ्योरम 6.7, स्टेटमेंट 180. This statement we are using since 6th, 7th standard, right? This is called angle sum property. Of triangle. Statement, sum of the angles of a triangle is 180. Let me draw a figure. PQR is a triangle. This is angle 1, 2, and 3. Now, data. Triangle PQR is given and angle PQR are three angles of triangle PQR to prove. Angle P plus Q plus R is equals to 180. Now, for that, we are drawing line XY and we will get 4 and 5 angle. Now prove. Let us draw a line XPY parallel to QR. Let us draw a line XPY parallel to QR, right? Through the opposite vertex P as per figure. Now, XPY is a line and straight angle. So XPY is a line and a straight angle. Therefore, we can give number angle 4 plus 1 plus 5 is equals to 180. Is it right? 4 plus 1 plus 5 is equals to 180. Straight angle. 4 plus 1 plus 5, 180. Straight angle. Now, angle 4 is equals to 2. That is alternate angle. And 5 is equals to 3. That is also alternate angle. So can we write like this? 2 plus 1 plus 3 is equals to 180. I am replacing. In place of 4, I have written 2. In place of 5, I have written 3. Is it all right? Say yes. Is it all right?
Yes, sir.
So 1 plus yes, 2 sir. Plus 3 is 180. So can I write 1 is equals to P, 2 is equals to Q, 3 is equals to R is equals to 180. Proved. Therefore, angle P plus Q plus R is equals to 180. Is it okay?
Yes.
Okay. Now, theorem number 6.8. If a side of triangle is produced, then exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of the two interior opposite angles. Important statement. Please remember. If a side of a triangle, this concept already I have taught you. The exterior angle concept. Do you remember? Exterior angle is equal to sum of two interior opposite angles.
Yes.
I have just mentioned in the last lecture. Exterior angle is equal to sum. Yes, it is coming now. If a side of a triangle is produced, then the exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of two interior opposite angles. Exercise 6.3. Sum number 1. Figure 6.9 indicates this way. Right? This is triangle PQR. And S and T are extended points. Side OP, QP, QP and QR, RQ are extended, right? At point S and T. SPR 135, SPR, this is 135. And PQT 110. PQT, this is 110. Find PRQ, this one. Okay. Now let me first explain it orally. If this is 135, this two will make linear pair. So 180 minus 135, angle P will be 45. Same way, these two will form linear pair. So 180 minus 110, this angle will be 70. Now 70 plus 45, 115, and minus 180. So this angle will be 65. Right? This angle will be 65. Now let's do it. Angle SPR plus angle QPR, 180. Linear pair. 135 plus QPR, 180. QPR is equals to 180 minus 135. That is 45. This angle. Second, always do the sums in this way. Whatever you find, give an arrow point. Now, angle PQT plus PQR, 180, linear. 110 plus PQR, 180. PQR is equals to 180 minus 110. So PQR is 70. So PQR is equals to 180 minus 110, that is 70. Now, in triangle PQR, angle PQR plus QPR plus PRQ, 180. You can write reference theorem number 6.7, angle sum property of triangle. Now PQR is 70, QPR is 45, plus PRQ, 180. So total 115 plus PRQ, 180. PRQ is equals to 180 minus 115. PRQ is equals to 65. PRQ is equals to 65. Getting? Everyone? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Question number 2. Sum number 2. Figure number 6.40. Let's draw first. Triangle X, Y, Z is given. O is a point. This whole angle is 54. And X, Y, Z, whole angle is 54. And YO and ZO are the bisector of XYZ and ZXY. YO, bisector of angle XYZ, ZO, bisector of angle XZY. Meaning here is, these two angles are equal and these two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. Now, angle X is 62 given. Find OZY. OZY and YOZ. Okay. Now, first of all, angle X plus Y plus Z, 180. Angle sum property, 62 plus 54 plus Z is equals to 180. Total 116 plus Z, 180. So Z is equals to 180 minus 116. Z is equals to 64. Now, you are told YO is bisector of XYZ. Therefore, understand, if this is whole 54, this half will be 27. That is, if XYZ is 54, therefore angle OYZ is 27. Half 10, 8. Same way, OZ is bisector of XZY. Therefore, XZY is 64. We have already found, right? Therefore, OZY is 32. Half 10 it. Half 10 it. First question, OZY, they want us to find. First answer, we got it. Right? Half. Now, in triangle OYZ, YOZ, OYZ, OZY, 180. YOZ we have to find. OYZ is 27. OZY is 32, 180. So YOZ is equals to 180 minus 59. Answer is 121. Answer is 121. Sum number 3. Another figure is given. AB is parallel to DE. AB is parallel to DE and BAC is given 35 and CDE is given 53. Find BCE. Very easy. Now, if this is 35, can you see this is Z? See, this is Z.
Yes, sir.
So, can I write this is 35?
Yes, sir.
Alternate angle pair.
Alternate.
Right? Now, 53 and 35 total, 88. Yeah. So, here it will be 92. Getting?
Yes.
Okay. Now, let's describe by method. Always try to do this sum orally first and then solve it by method. Right? See, AB is parallel to DE. Therefore, angle BAC is equal to angle CDE 35. Alternate. Now, in triangle CDE,
તમે જ્યાં ઉપર CDE લખ્યું છે,
CED. Now in triangle CDE, CDE plus CED plus DCE 180. CDE already given in question 53. CED 35 plus DCE 180. Total 88 plus DCE is equals to 180. DCE 180 minus 88. DCE is equals to 92. DCE is equals to 92. Now question number 4. In figure 6.42. Now, some number 4. Let's draw figure. P, R, D, Q, S. This is a triangle. This angle is 95. 40, 75. Now PQ, and RS intersect at T such that CRT 40, RPT 95, and TSQ 75. We have to find SQT, this one. Now first what we will do? By angle sum property of triangle, we'll find this angle, right? For example, 95 and 40, 135. If we subtract from 180, this will be 45. Now this is vertically opposite. So again, this will be 45. 45 and 75, total 120. If we subtract from 180, this angle will be 60. This angle will be 60. Getting everyone? How I done? I have been getting everyone?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Now let's write all in triangle PRT. Angle TPR plus angle TRP plus PTR 180. First one 95. Second one is 40 plus PTR 180. Therefore, PTR is equals to 180 minus 135, that is 45. Now, PTR is equals to QTS into bracket vertically opposite. Right? Always don't remember to write this. Otherwise, they will cut your marks. Vertically, you have to mention the reason for the equivalence. Right? Equal. A vertically opposite angle. Now, in triangle QTS. Angle QTS plus angle TSQ plus angle SQT 180. This is 45. TSQ is 75. SQT 180. 120 plus SQT 180. SQT is equals to 180 minus 120. That is 60. Now, number 5, 6.43. PQRSP. Now this is perpendicular. PQ is perpendicular to PS. So it is 90 degree already given. This is angle X. This is angle Y. 38 and it is 65. Okay. Now understand. PQR, RQ, QRT, they will form Z. Is it all right? Z. Can you see it? Z.
Yes, sir.
Angle PQR is equals to angle QRT. Now PQR is formed by two angles. PQS plus SQR is equals to 65. So X plus 38, 65. X is equals to 65 minus 38, 27. X is equals to 27. Is it all right?
Yes, sir.
Is it all right? 27. Out of 65, if you subtract 38, this will be 27. Now, in triangle PQS, angle PSQ, SPQ, and PQS, 180, PSQ is Y, SPQ is 90, PSQX is a 27, we have already found. So Y is equals to 180 minus 117. Y is equals to 63. So you can write final answer. X is equals to 27. Y is equals to 63. Sum number 6. In a figure 6.44, let's draw it. P, Q, R, S, T. Now, data. This is proof sum. Side. QR of triangle PQR is produced to a point S. Angle QT is bisector of angle PQR and RT is bisector of angle PRS to prove PRS and meet at T to prove angle QTR is half angle QPR. QTR is half angle QPR. Now prove. Now PRS is the exterior angle of triangle PQR. PRS is exterior angle of triangle PQR. Now therefore, PRS is equals to QPR and PQR addition. QPR plus PQR. Now therefore, 1/2 PRS is equals to, we are taking half of it, is equals to 1/2 QPR plus 1/2 PQR. Now, 1/2 PRS, half PRS is TRS. We can write TRS here. TRS, half QPR plus half PQR is TQR, half PQR, we understand, half PQR is TQR, this one is half, this angle is half. Now, TRS TRS is exterior angle of triangle TQR, right? Now TRS is exterior angle of triangle TQR. Therefore, TRS is equals to sum of QTR, QTR and TQR. Now these two are TRS. One number and two number. We can compare both of them. So directly I am writing 1/2 QPR plus TQR is equals to QTR plus TQR. Now from both the side we can cut TQR, TQR. So it is proved QTR is equals to 1/2 QPR. QTR is equals to 1/2 QPR.